we have a lovely arbi gravy. Hi, hello, vanakkam, welcome to the Recipes. I am Kancha Jayakumar. We have a lovely arbi gravy. This is a very simple method, yet a very delicious and a beautiful gravy, which it will go well with naan, chapatis, rotis, and even rice. So here we have the arbis. Just wash them and then put it into your pressure cookers and leave it for at least 2 to 3 pressure whistles, so that you know they get cooked soft, but at the same time they do not lose their shape and become very, very, very soft. So it should be in that state. So I've already cooked that, and I will show you how it has come out in the cooker. So look at this, it's soft, but at the same time they are in shape. We'll peel the skin. So here we have, make it into desired size, like, you know, you can make it into such small pieces. Now we have this ready, so let's do the masala preparation. Some lemon juice. Those who are allergic to lemon juice can add this tamarind juice. Just small pinch of sambar powder. Same way, half spoon of chili powder. Add salt. Mix this well together. The lemon juice is to just remove the itchy character or tendency if the arbi is going to possess. So here, place your fry pan or your dosa pan on the stove. Pour some oil. Now simultaneously, onto another stove, place your pan where you are going to do the gravy. Now we have already put all the masala and made this arbi. So let us place it on the dosa pan. Into the other pan where we are going to do the gravy, let us mildly roast the coconut and jeera. Coconut. You can use anything, fresh or the desiccated one. They are roasted now, so let's remove it. Let's add this to the small mixer jar. So here it is. Now let's cool. Let us allow this to cool, and then we will grind it. Now to the same vessel, we are going to add the onions and garlic. If you are using small garlics, it's okay. Otherwise, you can even cut these garlic. Add some salt to it. Salt for 2 minutes until they shrink or they change the color. Look at this. The arbis are getting roasted so well. They are sorted to some extent. Now let's add the tomatoes. Now the tomatoes also should get sorted so well. So what we'll do is we'll just cover it with a lid and leave it for 3 minutes. So they will blend together with the onions and look very nice. I'm going to grind this now. Just have a look at this. We are able to mash the tomatoes. So they are sorted that nicely. Now let's add the tamarind paste or the tamarind juice. Now let's add turmeric powder to this and allow it to boil nicely. Now let's add the sambar powder or the dhania powder. Now after adding all the powders, just give it a nice mix like this, and still the gravy will be boiling. At that stage, let's add the roasted arbis. And lastly, we are going to add the ground masala, that is the coconut. Now add little water to this, not much of water, because what will happen is the gravy will become very liquid consistency. So we need not want that, we want it into a gravy consistency. That's why we are going to add very little water to the mixer jar. And now keep it in low flame and allow it to get cooked well for at least 10 to 15 minutes, and the gravy will settle down and you'll see oil drop on the top surface. Now you can test for salt, and if it required, you can add some salt to this. So now after 10 minutes, you can see some oil spots on top surface. So that means the gravy has come to the right consistency and they have blended well together. So let's season it and then serve. You can use any kind of oil, but especially if you're going to use coconut oil, this is going to give a nice flavor to this gravy. Now add the hing, fenugreek, and the mustard seeds. Now add the curry leaves once they start to splutter. So here our arpi gravy is ready to be served. So here we have the arpi gravy ready to be served, and it's flavory, it's very nice and soft texture. It's going to be really yummy. Do try this and keep us posted. Dosetti Pizza is all about enhancing your taste buds. If you like this video, press like and subscribe to Dosetti Pizza. Thank you and bye-bye.